Hello Gundam fans, this is Brown92, and today I'll be looking at the super deformed Sengoku Astray Gundam from the Gundam Build Fighter series. So, this is the second in the Build Fighter Cheaper SD line, and looks pretty good. It does have some hollow pieces, like in the back of the legs, and the hands, but the hands have always been hollow, pretty much. The legs are definitely hollow. They kind of look like they could put something over them. Look at these two spots right here. I don't know. And you do have some stickers. You got the forehead camera, back of the head, the eyes, the gold mustache piece, all the little metallic green pieces. Which are fine. That's okay. But then the feet. The red is made up of two stickers. Which is really bad, considering the old SD Astray had a separate piece of plastic for the red. Which is just, yeah, and yeah, hollow feet, meh. But that really bugs me. It really does. Especially since this is a red, and then they put the white on top. They could have done that here. Red piece, black on top. I think that would look better. He holds together all right. This shoulder piece, the other one's okay. This one hates staying on. It really does. And the arms are a little loose here. They come off the ball joint a little too easily. They'll hold a pose, but if you start moving it, they come off. But it looks pretty good. Love the V-fin. Love how big it is. Articulation-wise, does have the ball joint and neck, like the other SDs. You got the ball joint at the torso, so I can go forward at the arm. And rotate. Ugh, this shoulder armor. See, without the shoulder armor, this arm is actually pretty articulate, just like any other SD. You can bend at the elbow, rotate at the wrist, but with the shoulder armor, it pretty much gets rid of all that. Because it's so big that it just stops all the articulation, except for, like, the hand. Which, it's annoying, but it's kind of the way it was built. It's the way that it's designed, like the actual mobile suit. In order to have this ornamentation, you have to sacrifice the arm articulation. Now you got the double-jointed waist, ball-jointed leg, and ball-jointed foot. So it's still the same as the other ones, just the arms are very limited. And it does have the helmet you can take off. I like the fact that they give a normal Gundam face underneath. So you still have the actual whole face here, just plop it on. And you still have the arms, which are, like I said, ball jointed at the top, and they're swiveled down here. So you can still use those. Still got the shield, which you can have them hold. Like that. And you still have the katanas, which I wish they had chromed these, or at least done them in white plastic. I don't like them in the gray-black plastic. They're nicely detailed. Long handles. And you can hold them. And they can also be held in the hands, which I think is why they're so long. Right like that. That's pretty nice. And you can also store them on the shoulder armor. Right like that. So everything works the way it's supposed to. Now, unfortunately, there is a gimmick mode which involves the shield. These two pegs that are obviously here for something. So you have to take the shoulder armor off. And the arms are going to go... If you notice, it has like a T-shape right here. So basically the arms are going to go into where they were plugged in on the actual Gundam arms. Like that. And let's give him the other sword. And then these little holes that were for the ball joints here are now going to go onto the pegs on the shield. Which do have tiny little ball joints. Like that. And now you have a puppet mode. That's the only thing I can think of when I see that. He's holding a puppet. He's going to start hacking and slashing people. Actually, it'd be kind of cool if you could, like, release it. And it just start flying around and cutting people up. That is weird. Very weird. I It's unique. It's definitely unique. Never seen a puppet mode before on a Gundam. I don't think. G Gundam might have done it. I don't know. But it is definitely weird. So let me just get this guy back to normal. Alright, so even though it had that weird mode, it doesn't really detract from the overall figure because I didn't even know these were part of it. And these pegs, you can easily cut them right off. It's not a big deal. So aside from that, it's a nice kit. It does have more stickers. These feet are really bad. This is my biggest problem. Should have had a red piece of plastic right there. But aside from that, it does need some paint, like any other SD, but it's not too bad. It's a pretty decent SD. Now, it is in scale with the newer SDs, as you can see. And I think the main reason they give us a Gundam face underneath is so you can do this. Just, it is a whole swappable armor gimmick they're going for. I kinda like that. That actually looks pretty good. And you can also pull off the friend skirt and also the shoulders and the weight on the arms. And let's show off the old Astray red frame. Obviously shorter, not as bulky looking because of the armor, but it has the red plastic on the feet, which, and it even has toe, look at this, it has toe articulation. It is gappy on the side of the legs, but this guy's gappy on the back. So I still really like this SD, the old SD, but it even has better shoulder. It actually has superior articulation. The Astrays back in the day definitely got a lot more love than the other mobile suits in model form. It was weird. So yeah, I kind of want to try and give him his parts, or give him his parts. That would be kind of cool, but yeah, they're both nice. So that is the new Sengoku Astray Gundam SD, and it's pretty cool. I like it, and it has some problems. Obviously, the arms are very limited. Thankfully, you have the extra arms, so that's not too bad. That weird puppet thing is stupid. It's just it's there. It's unique. But it is an all right SD for being a cheaper one. So that's about it, and I'll see you at the next review.